Okay, so good day class. So this is the continuation of the topic, the maximization problem. Okay, so we have the problem. Number one, the MSS car rental agency plans to purchase a 5 new automobile. Okay, automobile. Sige, to replace 5 older vehicles, the older vehicles are to be sold. Okay, are to be sold to at auction. Okay, sige. So the agency has solicited, okay, from 5 individuals, so each home wishes to buy only one vehicle, but agreed to make a sell bid on each of the 5. Sorry. So the bids are as follows in terms of 10,000. Okay, so here is the table. Ito yung mga bidding natin, 10,000. Okay. So example, so this is our buyer, different buyers and the automobile. Sige. We have the different type of brand. Okay, mga vehicles, Toyota, Mitsubishi, Ford, Nissan and Mazda. Okay, so in terms of 10,000 yung mga amount niya. So 12 times 10,000 and yan, 120,000. So by in terms of 10,000 lang po. Okay, so by 12. Okay, so yan po ang mga amount niya. So the agency wishes to determine which bid to accept from each of the 5 bidders, so that each of them can buy one vehicle while the total of the 5 accepted bids is maximum. Okay? So here is the step 1. Step 1. So we are going to identify the highest value in each row and subtract it each row from the highest value appearing to that row. Plus we are going to find the maximum amount or the maximization problem. So here in our problem class doon sa ating first problem, di ba? We are going to find the minimum. So here we are going to find the highest amount. Okay, so in our row 1, as you can see in our row 1, the higher amount is yung 20. In the row 2 naman, si 14, di ba? Okay, under in column E, di ba? Column E. So, and the row 3 naman, yung highest is 10, and column 4 is the highest is column 11. And number 5 naman, yung highest amount is 14. And then we are going to subtract, okay, highest, okay, yung highest amount minus the lowest amount. So sige, yung 20 minus mo dito sa ating row 1. So 20 minus 12, 8. 20 minus 20, 0. 20 minus 10, 10. 20 minus 8, 12. And 20 minus 7, 13. 14 minus 10, 4. 14 minus 13, 1. 14 minus 11, 3. 14 minus 9, 5. Then 14 minus 14, 0. And so on. So lahat, minus mo dito yung 10 sa lahat ng row 3. And this is the resulting part. And yung 11 naman, minus mo sa lahat ng row 4. And yung 14 naman, minus sa lahat ng row 5. And then, step 2. Select the minimum entry in each column and subtract it from every entry in that column. And now, we are going to find the column reduction. Okay, so, in finding the column reduction naman, so ito yung row reduction. So, ito yung column reduction. So, in a column reduction, so in our column A, from column E, so we're going to find the minimum amount. So itong 2, yung 0, yung sa column C, 0, and column D, row, yung number 2, and the column E, 0. Yes. Sige. First year, dali siya. Sige. Okay. So, next naman. Okay, next ha. Okay. So minus mo ito, lahat ng column minus mo ng 2, lahat ng column B minus ng 0, then lahat ng column C minus ng 0, lahat ng column D minus ng 2, then lahat ng column E minus ng 0. So 8 minus 2, 6. 4 minus 2, 2. 5 minus 2 equals 3, then 2 minus 2 equals 0, then 4 minus 2 equals 2. Then, and also 0 minus 0, 0, 1 minus 0, 1, then 4 minus 4, 4 minus 0 is 4, then 4 minus 0 is 4, then 0 minus 0 is 0, and so on. Column C, lahat ng column C minus ng 0, and lahat ng column D minus ng 2, then lahat ng column E is minus ng 0. Ito yan. And next naman is step 3. So determine if 5 unique assignments exist in table 3 by drawing the minimum number, okay, of horizontal or vertical lines necessary to cross out all 0 through the rows and columns of the tableau. Okay, so in our next table class, we are going to highlight all the table that have a unique 0. Sige, first, okay, so first, you are going to find the unique row ha, na may nag-iisang 0. So, sino yung unique row naman na nag-iisang 0? Di ba ito? Yan. Okay, siya lang isa, di ba, sa row 1. Dito is siya lang isa. And dito sa row 3 is siya lang isa. And sa row 4 naman is merong kasama. Okay? And dito sa row 5 plus, isa lang yan. Okay, shade mo lang. Okay, i-shade mo. Pag row ganun yung unique row, yung highlight mo is pa-column. Highlight mo yung column niya. Lahat. Then next naman, so i-erase ko yan ha. Okay. So unique na column. So sino yung unique na column na may nag-iisang 0? So di ba ito? Ito na column. So ito lang. Di ba? So lahat ng row 4. Okay. I-highlight mo yan. Then after highlight that specific row and column, identify the minimum value which is 1. Diba? In our table class, except the highlighted column and row, except yung mga highlight, sino yung pinakamaliit na number dito? Diba? So only 1 ang pinakamaliit. Then and next, so the 4 lines indicated there are only 4 unique assignments, whereas 4 are required for an optimal solution since it is a 4x4 matrix. 4x4 ba na eh? 5. Okay, 5x5 ito. Sige. 5x5 ito. Sige. Subtract 1 from all the values in table 3. So all the values here in our table, subtract by 1. Except, okay, except the highlighted row, the highlighted number, except lang ha. And also, the intersectional number ito. Ito yung mga intersectional number, di ba? And ito. Okay? And ito. Okay, yan po ang mga intersectional number. So, plus 1 ka dyan. Okay, subtract 1, yung mga unhighlighted number. Then, copy mo yung highlighted number and subtract plus 1 to the intersection point. So 6 minus 1, 1. Copy mo yung 0 lahat ng column dito. Okay, except si 4, add ka ng 1. Except intersectional point ito. Add si 1. Okay? So lahat ng mga unhighlighted column o row and number minus 1 pa. So ito na yung resulting part niya. 6 minus 1, 5. 2 minus 1, 1. 3 minus 1, 2. Then 2 minus 1, 0. 4 plus 1, 5. 1 plus 1, 2. Then 0 plus 1, 1. Then 10 minus 1, 11. 9 man ito. Okay. 9 yan. Sabi. Check ko ha. Ah, 9 ito. saying. Oh, yan. Check ko ha. Wait lang kasi. Okay, so let me check first. So 9 yan plus 2. Oh, 3 minus 1, 2. Then 1 minus 1, 0. 0 and 1. Okay, 9 yan ha and 2. Next naman is the step 6. Okay, so in our step 6 class, we are going to find the highlight, the unique solution. So apply the line test again to determine if an optimal solution already exists. So the second iteration, the opportunity cost tableau with the line test. Okay. So mag-highlight naman tayo. Okay? So next sa highlight class, hanapin natin yung unique na row, okay? Na may nag-iisang zero. So 'di ba ito? Highlight mo 'yan. Ito, highlight mo yan. Nag-iisang zero yan na row. And dito naman sa column naman class, nag-iisang highlighted column, nag-iisang unique na zero sa column. So, di ba ito? Oh, sa highlighted column. So, highlight mo yan. And ito naman, yung zero, is nag-iisang dito sa C. So, highlight mo yan lahat. And that would be your highlighted row and column. So, next naman is hanapin natin yung yung minimum value in our table, yung unhighlighted number. So ito, di ba? So next natin gawin is yon. Lahat ng mga unhighlighted numbers minus mo ng 1, lahat ng intersectional number plus 1 ka. Okay? Plus 1 ka. So yan. Okay, tama. Okay, plus 1 ka. Sige. Yun, na yung mga sipiat rin, no? Sige, 5 minus 1, 1 minus 1, 2 minus 1. Ito, 4 plus 1, then 5 plus 1. Diba? So, ito, plus 1 ka. Plus 1. So, ito class is 9 ito. Di ba? 9 and 2 ito. 9 and 2. Tama. 9. So, 9 ito. So, yun. 10 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 9 minus 1, 2 minus 1, 1 minus 1. Ito yung final answer. So, 5 minus 1, 4. 1 minus 1, 0. Copy yung 2. Yung copy yung 0. 1 minus 1, 0. Then, 0. Copy yung 1, 4. Lahat ng mga. Okay? 4 plus 1, 5. Okay? So, 5 ito klasa. So, 5 plus 1, 6 ito. 9, 2, 0, 2, 1. 8, 9 minus 1, 8, 2 minus 1, 1, 0, 0, and 0, then 13, 0, 5 plus 1, 6, 1 plus 1, 2, and 8. Sige. So, merong mga typographical error, no, sa ating module. Sige. Then, after that, highlight mo yung. Okay, or pwede na lang wag nang mag-highlight sa last part. Sige. Yung hanapin natin yung is mag-create tayo ng mga box and cross yung mga hindi kasali na zero. So hanapin natin yung unique na row. So sino yung unique na row dito? 'Di ba ito? Only row 1 lang, no. Okay, only row 1. So that means okay. Box natin 'yan. So, ito, X na yan. Next naman is hanapin natin yung unique na column. Okay, so ito yung unit na column, di ba? Okay. So yan. So ito is x na yan. Sino pa? Okay, ito. Okay, so ito x na yan. Na unit ha. So dito sir is ano na? Okay, class. Dapat mag-start ka sa column 1. Okay, sa column 1 ka mag-start. So ito yung una. Huwag ito. Ito yung una. Okay, mag-start ka sa column 1. And ito is x na yan. So x na ito. And box ito. Okay. So the final answer class ay ito. Okay, so 1 B na may 0, 2 A and E, number 3 C, number 3 C and D, number 4 A and D, number 5 okay A B D. So next naman is hanapin natin yung unique, yung may box na 0. So in our buyer 1, so sino yung may box dyan na 0? So di ba si 1 and B, ito si ito si B, column B. Sa row 2 naman is si E, and sa row 3 naman is si C, and sa row 4 naman is row 4 is si A, column A, and sa row 5 is column D. So the order assignment, first, second, third, fourth, and fifth, and the amount. So sir, bakit naging 2,000? So di ba 10,000 yung term? So yon, 1 and B. So si 1 and B is dito, balik tayo dito, balik tayo. 1 and B, ito 1 and B, di ba 20,000? Ayan. So 20,000 times 10,000, 20 times 10,000, so yon, 200,000. Next naman, si 2 and si E. Si 2 and E class, E, balik ko ha. Si 2 and E is 14. So 14 times 10,000, 140,000. Si C naman, 3 and C, 10. So 10 times 10,000, 100,000. Then si 4 naman, 4 and D. So 10 ba yan si 4 and D? Okay, so 100,000. Ah, 90,000 pala. 90,000. Then, si 5. Hindi ito. 90,000 ito ha. Si 5 naman. 5 and A. 10. 10 times 10, 100,000. So, the total amount class. 200 plus 140 plus 100 plus 90 plus 100. Is equal to 630,000. So the assignment distribution shown resulted to the most efficient assignment of buyers to the automobile pala, is equal to 630,000. Okay, and that's all. Thank you.